Hope everyone's having a good Tuesday, but you know what makes Tuesdays even better? A commitment. And that's what Oklahoma just got in four-star offensive lineman Eugene Brooks out of Sierra Canyon out of Chatsworth, California. Originally a Nevada kid, by the way. Moved to California recently. But a composite three-star, but Rivals and ESPN have him as a four-star. 24/7 and On3 have him as a three-star, respectively. So they got him composite three. That could change in the upcoming weeks or months. But regardless, anytime anyone poo-poos a composite three-star or whatever, you just have to look at who offered him. OU offered him, Texas offered him, SC, Georgia, Texas A&M, Florida State. Pretty decent list of teams who offered this kid. So, offensive line getting some needed depth in the interior. This guy was definitely going to be an interior offensive line. Already 6'3", 325, according to On3. And the ball keeps rolling for Oklahoma. He's like commit, what, number 16 or 17 right now? Let's take a look, see here. I should have had that up already, but commit number 17, it looks like. So, number 16, I should say. I was looking at other things. Anyway, the point of the matter is, he's been on a little bit of a roll lately. The next one that we expect him to announce is on the 31st, and I believe that is in-state safety, Michael Patterson McDonald, because I always mix up his last name. Sometimes I say McDonald first, but it's Patterson McDonald. Three-star in-state safety, Michael Patterson McDonald, expected to announce on July 31st. And after that, we're not quite sure on, because August could potentially be a big month for OU, as I mentioned in previous videos. But, everyone's waiting for the big August push for potential defensive lineman that could commit. So got to be patient on that front. But it is amazing to me just kind of reading, The Athletic recently, and people are asking questions about, who's doing well in recruiting or who's overachieving, who's underachieving. And we have, Ari Wasserman, who was a big critic of Brent year one when he announced his recruiting preferences or his recruiting strategy. Not really keen on saying, once you commit, you're not allowed to take other visits. And, of course, like at some point, Ari Wasserman had a one-on-one interview with Brent, and he had him a little sip of the Kool-Aid, and he changed his mind just a tad. And according to Ari, USC, not recruiting as well as they thought they would, and Oklahoma, with Brent, recruiting a lot better than he thought. So, hey, what are the odds there? But there's just one thing you can look at is that OU's going to be recruiting just fine. This class is the first SEC class, and 2025 looks to be special as well. But that's for another video for another day. But just the excitement's there, and we're inching ever so closer to the season. We're about 5.5 weeks out. This is the kind of the time of year where things start to slow down. I always like to make fun. It's like everyone's like, football's almost here. It's like once you start admitting that football is almost here, that's when time slows down. And so I think we're pretty much at that point right now on the 25th of July. Time's going to really slow down. As I said before, August, there's a lot of smoke about Williams Wenari. Week of August 1st or week of August 7th. And it's OU Missouri. It's OU Georgia. It's this and this. Like, there's one constant. It's Oklahoma. And just let's just take a moment real quick. Because I don't want to, we talked about Eugene Brooks a little bit. It's a great commitment, but everyone wants to talk about the big boys up front. I don't think people are prepared if OU gets Williams Wenari. It's not just a really good defensive lineman. It's not even just a five-star defensive lineman. It's the number one recruit in the country right now. You can argue here and there whether the QB at Georgia or whatever. You get one of the prime spots for recruiting, the highest rated, that sends a message. I think that'll send a shockwave. And people will say, well, yeah, it's Oklahoma. This is like, OU doesn't get these recruits like they used to. Like, that's dipped over the past 10 years or so, probably longer. And for OU to get this guy and potentially others to follow, like David Stone and Nigel Smith and who else. I just think it's, you know, once that ball starts rolling, that's when people's eyes are really going to start opening. And then, like, I don't know what Brent's going to be as a head coach game day wise yet, because that's still to be determined. Man, recruiting's not suffering at the moment. So, if August goes down like we all hope it can, like we think it can, like it's, you know, being projected it might, it's going to be a really good start to the football season. Because I'll tell you what, football season, when it gets here for OU, the schedule is very weak. Everyone's already putting in their narratives that even if OU wins 10 games, it's a weak schedule. I'm not going to disagree with that. But the narrative's already been laid down. They already have the preemptive narrative if OU does well, in case people are just hating or they just want things to not go away. They want all their predictions to come true. But I feel momentum for this year. I really do. I feel like it's going to be different. I don't think it's going to be great or elite or anything, but I think it'll be just enough to get us into the SEC in 24, and then who knows what kind of noise we'll make when we get there. So, I know I say stuff like this every other video, it seems, but it's just, like, again, we're just getting so close. Like, we're just waiting for camp to start. We need new stuff to talk about. Media days has already passed, so just kind of filling the gap, but you know what fills the gap very nicely? Getting some really good commitments. 4-star offensive linemen. I'll take that any day of the week. All right, so with that being said, not expecting any commitments till the 31st, obviously, as I mentioned before. If anything else pops up before then, I'll be here to talk about it. Anything else I just want to feel like I could talk about, I might come up with some stuff to talk about. It's still talking season, some thoughts and whatnot. But until then, y'all have a good one. Boomer Sooner.